Welcome everyone to Retro Game Treasure Tuesday. And as always, we'll be using our highly advanced grading system to see just how good this month's box really is. As you can see, we got this weird generic box with a sticker on it, I'm assuming because what's in here wouldn't fit in a normal RGT box. But what could that be? Well, we got this Sega Genesis controller. Now, it may not be an original, it is from Retrobit, but hey, I'm not gonna pass up free crap. Now, you may be thinking, James, I'm pretty sure people got that in December's box. All right, I admit it. I film videos a month in advance. I apologize. I'm a fraud. Unsubscribe. Stop watching. Please don't do that. Please. Please don't. Does it really matter? We all know you're just here for my sexy good looks and fantastic reviews. Anyway, let's check out Smurf Racing on the PS1. You know, I'll be honest, I never really watched Smurfs.
Of course, I'm aware of Papa Smurf and Smurfette, but never really knew the names of the others. You know, Sneezy, Dopey, Happy, Cantankerous, and Jeff. My biggest problem with kart racers is it's really hard to not compare them to Mario Kart. And typically that's an unfair comparison, so I'm gonna try to not do that. The graphics are what you would expect from the PS1. They look okay, I guess. They're not as good as, say, Mario Kart 64, oh, son of a bitch. The controls do feel a bit loose at first, but you do get used to it. They're nowhere near as polished as Mario Kart. Motherfucker! I do like how each area has multiple tracks to race. I did have some trouble with the item system though. I wasn't quite sure what I was doing, but didn't really care at the moment to figure it out. Also, I didn't understand the purpose of the penis rockets. Yeah, I know they're probably mushrooms, whatever. I wasn't sure if I was supposed to shoot them at the other racers or what.
I'll be honest, I didn't play this game for long, but it didn't seem horrible. I do plan on starting a new series of videos this year, so maybe I'll add this to the list of games I want to review. I'll give it a C. Next up, we got Star Wars Battlefront 2 on the PSP. Yeah, I couldn't get this game to work. I'm pretty sure it's my PSP, as I've had issues in the past with it being difficult, but I thought in lieu of gameplay footage, why not give you guys an accurate representation of how much work went into getting that little bit of game footage. Alright, I need my PSP. I need the capture card too. I need the component cable too. Of course, it's not charged. Son of a bitch. Anyway, I know people love this game, but since I didn't get the case for it and I couldn't even play it, I'm gonna give it a C. Last up, we got Star Force on the NES. I've mentioned this before, but I hated these games as a kid.
But I've grown to love them over the years, and this one didn't disappoint. It's hard as hell, but that's to be expected, I guess. I did make it to the first boss without losing a life, and died immediately. I think that's my biggest problem with these games. I seem to always have beginner's luck. I'll end up doing some crazy-ass maneuvers and whatnot, and when I die and try again, I'll constantly run into the only enemy or bullet on screen. It took several attempts, but I finally made it back to the boss, and he was easy as hell.
Anyway, I enjoyed this game more than I expected. I know there's better shooters out there, but you know what? I could see myself coming back to this one. I'm gonna give it a B. Well, anyway guys, that gives us another surprising score of C. But to be honest, if I had gotten the case for Battlefront 2, it could have been different. Anyway, thanks again for watching guys. You know what to do, like, comment, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you again